the 2015 Mid-Season Invitational coming to you live from the campus of Florida State University as we are gearing up for Game 3 between SKT and Fnatic. And Fnatic, they made some adjustments and they made it work, and the most notable adjustment must be their very own confidence, individual players stepping it up in Game 2.
Yeah, that's a big deal here for Fnatic. They get now confirmation they can beat SK Telecom. Yesterday, they had a good start to the game, did manage to close it out. Then in Game 1 here, there were some mistakes they fell behind. This time around, though, Febiven in the mid lane. The difference, I mean, it doesn't even look like the same player between Game 1 and Game 2. I'm not sure if Fnatic has a secret sub or anything, but 10-0 on LeBlanc.
His twin.
This is so good. His twin brother. Okay, there we go. Doing this against SK Telecom means he can do everything now.
Yeah, the thing is, it begins and ends with Huni in these games, because without Huni starting those advantages, he never would have given the rest of the team confidence to do so. I think the absolute priority for SKT in this game should be taking Huni off of playmakers whenever possible, because he makes so many plays.
Yeah, the Nautilus ban they have, I don't think it's needed. Yellowstar can play so many other engaged supports. So remove that one, add in the Rumble. That's a way to go. Maybe change up your first pick potentially. But we also have to mention how SK Telecom as a team, they won't really get affected by the fact they lost right here. I mean, they've been here before. They were down 0-2 against CG Entes, came back 3-2 anyway to even get to the final in the LCK. So they should be fine. This is more about what it means for Fnatic, getting that one win and getting the confirmation that we are a good team.
And there's a lot of subs that happened in that series as well, but this is the lineup for SKT, keeping Faker in with Bengi in the jungle. These are their grizzled veterans that know how to come back from a series, and they're not even down yet. This is a 1-1 series, and even though there was a 15,000 gold lead in that game, it still felt close, because SKT is a really hard team to close out. Trying to do that three times is no easy task.
Yeah, that is the question, of course. The chance that you're going to get a 10K to 15K gold lead once again for Fnatic is going to be a hard task. Do you think that because of that Game 2 experience, they have the tools to work with it and do it differently with maybe a slighter gold lead?
I think for Fnatic, what they're realizing is player-wise and strategy-wise, at least in the first 20 minutes, they are good enough to get this gold lead. The problem is you cannot make any mistakes. And that's where it becomes in here, because SK Telecom will punish you instantly. So if they get a bit more confidence saying, as long as we know what we want to do, as long as we pre-plan what's about to happen, we can make some plays. If they start falling back into this routine where they get a bad start, I can see it crumble completely and just lose in like 25 minutes.
Yeah, we will see what happens. We're going to go into game in just a second and throw it over to the caster boot. But for now, though, we're going to listen to Bang talking about what it means to come to an international tournament and play Koreans.
일단 반갑고, 네, 그래도 그 반가운 그 적이잖아요. 근데 적인데도 좀 반가움이 좀 앞서려고 하는데 그 감정을 좀 잡기가 힘들어요. 일단 최대한 적이라고 생각하려고 하는데 너무 반가워가지고 그리고 궁금한 것도 많고 재밌고 그렇긴 한데 이기려면 좀 긴장감이 더 중요해서 네 그래서 좀 재밌어요.
How can you not be happy seeing Huni?
Impossible.
Exactly. Every single person in this audience is happy seeing Huni, 1-1. But let's be serious. I think SKT lost a little bit of focus in that game. Itemization and individual plays were simply not up to what we're expecting out of this team and these guys.
Yeah, indeed. And what's really important to note as well is this is actually the first time that this iteration of SK Telecom with Faker has ever lost a game to a Western team. Previously, they had dropped one game to OMG and two games to Najin Black Sword at the Season 3 World Championship, of course, going undefeated in All-Stars last year. So this is really a huge moment for Fnatic to be that first person to even take a game, or first team to even take a game off SKT.
The question is, can Fnatic do it two more times?
And
because this is the only style they have. SKT can mix and match.
That's right, and if they could do that, it would be huge, because in the history of League of Legends, there's only been one Western team to ever defeat a Korean team at a best of five, and that was CLGEU over Najin Sword all the way back in the summer of 2012. So it would be just a phenomenal upset.
A long time coming in Huni NA Trust.